model 642 Smith and Wesson Centennial Airweight Revolver. Back in the 1950s, Smith and Wesson first produced the Centennial series. The Centennial series has a fully enclosed internal hammer, making it a double action only gun. Now they have two other revolvers that they've had through the years, the Chief Special, which is model 36, and it has a fully exposed hammer, double action, single action. They have the Bodyguard series, which has a shrouded hammer, also double action, single action, as you can still get to that hammer even though it's shrouded. Now this little model 642 Centennial Airweight first came out in 2006, and for the first time came out with their little snub nose in the plus P version. So this little guy shoots plus P's, not 357 Magnums, but it will shoot the little bit more powerful plus P's. Now this little gun is a 15 ounce, 5 round, full alloy frame, stainless steel cylinder, and stainless steel slightly under 2-inch barrel. Very nice little carry gun. It has a trigger that's a little bit more than 10 pounds out of the box. Now this one, I've had a trigger job done on it, which some people say don't ever do, but I've got a reputable gunsmith that lightens this up, smooths it a little bit, and my opinion makes a great gun greater. So this one has about an 8 to 10 pound very smooth trigger on it. It has an integral lock on the left side, just above the cylinder release, and then it has a synthetic grip, which I've replaced, or actually the factory replaced in this one, with the Crimson Trace grip because I wanted the laser sight on it. And then the laser sight, as you may know, is on the right side with the activation switch on the grip of the handle. So this is a very nice carryable gun, and that gets into really the biggest advantages of this little gun are its simplicity and carryability. From a carryability standpoint, a little 15 ounce very ergonomic gun like this with no exposed hammer makes it very nice to carry. It carries very nicely in the pocket or in a little pocket holster. From a simplicity standpoint, it just doesn't get any easier than this. Opposed to pistols, you know, where you've got your potential of having jams, having misfires, having to re-rack and things like that. You don't have to worry about any of that with this. There's no safeties to worry about. There's no decockers to worry about. There's only a few little things you can do. You can't do anything with a hammer. It's enclosed. So all you can do really is release your cylinder, put rounds in the cylinder, close it, aim and pull the trigger. That's it. A very simple gun to use. Now I didn't say that it makes it an easy gun to shoot accurately. It's an easy gun just to shoot. And I'll talk a little bit about this accuracy situation in a little bit, because with this short barrel on it and with the light gun and the kick with it, it makes it not as easy to shoot accurately as some of the other guns out there. To talk a little bit more about that, well, let's start cleaning this a little bit and then I'll talk about this accuracy part of this. This gun, when I got it, I knew that it was not going to be simple to shoot, because most of the little 2-inch revolvers are not. They're not real easy to shoot, but I had a little bit harder time than I thought I was going to have. I like to go out to the range and shoot at 30 to 45 feet when I'm working on my accuracy. Now, a lot of people state, well, you don't have to do that with these guns because they're a carry gun only. They're not a gun you want to go to the range with. You just want to carry them, and if you're in with 10 to 20 feet, that's all you need to do. Well, that just doesn't work for me. So I want to be able to shoot this accurately at those distances. And the other thing, I feel that if I can shoot accurately at 30 to 45 feet practicing, then when I'm scared, nervous, and all sort of things are going on, if I'm in a defensive situation, hopefully I can shoot accurately at 20 feet if I need to. Not a gun that you want to put in the purse or in the pocket of someone that's inexperienced and has no desire to practice. Because I think to shoot this gun and carry this gun defensively, that this gun has got to be practiced with. I do not shoot plus P's in this. I know a lot of people do and feel very good about it. I have a harder time getting back on target with a plus P. I have a hard enough time with a 38 getting back on target. In trigger control, I worked very hard on my trigger control on this, and that to me, that's where accuracy comes in, y'all. I want my trigger, when it breaks, I don't even know it broke. Just a total surprise. And when I'm shooting my best, I never know when the trigger breaks. And that's what I try to work on with all of my guns, and especially this little gun. I carry a good round in it, Hornady critical defense rounds or something similar to that. So I feel that those are good rounds. You know, as I talked about in another video, Bernard Goetz with a Model 60 had four rounds, had a five round gun, and it took him four rounds to take out four people that were attacking him on the subway. So it's not like the 38 special round is not a good round. No, it's not a 40 caliber or 45, but it'll do the job, especially, again, if you know how to accurately shoot it. A couple other things on the range I want to talk about. If I'm going to go out like today and shoot, practice my accuracy, I'm going to practice, as I was telling you, at 30, 45, and 60 feet. I work real hard on trigger control, and that's what I do the most when I'm working on accuracy. Now, a drill that I will do every time I go out is the Bill drill. Back in the late 70s, I think, or early 80s, Bill Wilson sent a drill to Rob Lethem and Brian Enos, and they are good friends today, obviously, too, but then they were in shooting competitions and great friends and young guys out working hard on their game. And Bill Wilson wanted them to try this drill out. This drill is very simple. Said, take a zone target, put it 21 feet from you, and see if you can put six bullets into the A zone at 2 seconds or under. And they can do that. I can't, and most of us can't do that. But that was the drill. If you missed the A zone, then it didn't count. You had to put all six of them in the A zone for that drill to count. A little bit about those guys. Rob Lethem's one of the greatest competition shooters that's ever lived, and Brian Enos is one of the most experts of just the ability and how to shoot of anyone out there. And he's got a great book, Practical Shooting, that you can get off of his website or out of Amazon, and that book will definitely make you better. It is a great book. It explains what shooting's about, how to shoot from not only us novice people, but to the more experienced people. Well, there's not much else to say about this little gun, and you can tell that it is one of my favorite guns, and it is one of my favorite carry guns, and we really appreciate your watching our videos. Hope you have a good one. We'll see you around, guys.